All right, now we're going to look at questions that are called difference of squares. And difference of squares are polynomials that will be in the form of a perfect square minus a perfect square. So for example, x squared minus 81. X squared is a perfect square. This has to be a minus sign in the question, and 81 is a perfect square. So to factor this, we open up our brackets just the same, and we square root the first term for the first number. So x squared, when you square root it, is x times x, which for the same reason we've been writing every time. Okay, then you square root the second term, 81. The square root of 81 is 9. That tells you what these numbers is. 9 times 9 is 81. Now the signs are always, always, always going to be a plus and a minus. Or you can write minus first, then plus. The reason that is when you check your outside and inside terms, you get plus 9x minus 9x, which of course cancels out, which is why there's no middle term. So whenever you do difference of squares, you square root the first term, the signs are plus or minus, you square root the second term. So that's what we're going to do throughout each of these examples. So let's look at example 2 together still one more time. So for example 2, a squared minus 36, the square root of a squared is a times a. My signs are always plus or minus. Square root of 36 is 6. I would like you to try example 3 and 4 before watching the next video.